I'm speaking to you at what I know is an increasingly challenging time. A time of disruption in the life of our country.
The late Queen Elizabeth II is the longest-serving British monarch and the second longest in world history. She celebrated her platinum jubilee on the throne this year, and the streets of Britain were lit with flags and people celebrating her. There is no one like her, but many actors have tried to do justice to her character and produced some memorable portrayals.
My lords, ladies, and commoners.
Here's a little commemoration from a site of the Queen's life, a list of the best portrayals of Queen Elizabeth II on screen. Number 1. The Crown, Claire 4. This Netflix masterpiece became a streaming sensation with Claire 4 donning the titular crown. The depiction of the young Queen's ascendancy and early years won her an Emmy Award and was the benchmark for a fabulous portrayal of Her Majesty to Coleman, who will be portraying the Queen in later seasons.
Tenets of Christianity. There is no possibility of my forgiving you. The question is, how on earth can you forgive yourself?
Number 2, The Queen, Helen Mirren. Winning her the Best Actress Oscar Award in the lead role for this depiction, Helen Mirren humanized Queen Elizabeth II in the post-Diana period. The movie itself received positive response from critics and is one of the most successful films where the Queen is portrayed in, set at one of the darkest times in the monarch's reign and public acceptance.
And it is my belief that they will any moment reject this mood, which is being stirred up by the press.
Number 3, The BFG, Penelope Wilton. Showing the crown in a more sassy and whimsical turn, Penelope Wilton gave a sterling portrayal of the Queen in this Roald Dahl's classic. In the movie, the monarch is portrayed as a kind ruler, one who loves the company of the friendly giant and his friend with comedic after effects.
It's glummy. Good boy, Snozcumber.
What's Snozcumber?
Number 4, Spencer, Stella Gonnett. Focusing on Lady Diana's Christmas with the royal family in 1991, Stella Gonnett breathed life to Her Majesty in Spencer. Gonnett took a more legal approach to the character in her antagonistic and near-captor act against Princess Diana, played by Kristen Stewart.
Wasn't the one Madrasa recommended. They take a lot of photographs of you, don't they? The only portrait really matters.
Number 5, William and Catherine, A Royal Romance, Jane Alexander. The film focuses on the impending marriage between Prince William and Kate, and Jane Alexander's depiction of Queen Elizabeth II shone through even though her character did not get much screen time. A rare portrayal of the crown by an American, Alexander puts an exquisite effort in characterizing the role of the future grandmother-in-law.
I know. I tried to advise you as best I could, but my views were colored by what my parents believed.
Number 6, The King's Speech, Freya Wilson. This Oscar-winning movie stars Colin Firth as King George VI, Helena Bonham Carter and Freya Wilson as the young Princess Elizabeth. Viewers are taken through the King's flight to overcome his stammer and how his daughter and future queen comfort and support him in this endeavor.
What's he saying?
I don't know, but he seems to be saying it rather well.
Your first wartime speech.
Broadcast to the nation and the world.
Number 7, The Crown, Olivia Colman. Essaying the Queen in her middle age, Coleman successfully weaves an uncanny performance during periods of crisis in the royal's reign and her various duties as sovereign. The myriad of quandaries included the Cold War, her sister Princess Margaret's divorce, troubles in Ireland and the wedding and aftermath of Princess Diana and Prince Charles' union, and Coleman played the part well, winning her an Emmy in the fourth season.
The idealized version of themselves they want to be seen, and the less desirable person they really are, hidden away.
Number 8, A Royal Night Out, Sarah Gadon. We don't often see a royal partaking in public celebrations quite like in this movie. Sarah Gadon is Princess Elizabeth on 1945's VED, where the night is filled with excitement, adventure and romance. Gadon manages to capture the royal's countenance and her grounded mannerisms in this delightful, charming, and entertaining fictional romantic comedy.
Chelsea Barrett.
Trafalgar Square. Soho.
Cheers.
Tonight, we're in charge. We can go dancing.
Number 9, The Simpsons, Dress MacNeil. This animated hit series featured the royal figure in their season 15th The Regina Monologue episode. Voiced by Dress MacNeil, the episode followed the Simpsons family as they travelled to England, greeted by Prime Minister Tony Blair and then slamming onto the Queen's horse-drawn carriage.
A tragedy, and then, as I was innocently making my way to the shops to buy light bulbs, I was blindsided by this great lumbering brute.
Number 10, Pennyworth, Jessica Ellerby. This alternate reality of Britain in the 1950s and 60s is the background for the origin story of Alfred Pennyworth, Batman's loyal butler. Ellerby plays an edgier version of young Elizabeth II in a portrayal that focuses on historically representing the crown accurately as opposed to a direct presentation. This different facet that the one we are used to seeing shows us a daring and decisive monarch with Machiavellian plans far from English royal standards.
I fear dark times lie ahead and loyalties will be tested.
Number 11, 2012 Summer Olympics, herself. In the cheeky appearance, we see the Queen holding an audience with James Bond himself, played by Daniel Craig, who then escorts her to the Olympic Stadium via helicopter. This sweet and fun sketch also features her beloved Gorgas and a parachute jump to the ceremony by stuntman Gary Connery, who doubles as Queen Elizabeth II.
Good evening, Mr. Bond.
Good evening, Your Majesty.
Thank you for watching. Let us know in the comments section below if you've missed a portrayal that you like. Please remember to like, subscribe, and ring the bell icon to be notified of new videos like this one.